Two more diplomats pay courtesy calls on President-elect Marcos Jr. at his headquarters in Mandaluyong City. ABS-CBN's Ina Reformina now joins us on the line with an update. Ina.
Casey, this morning, President-elect Bongbong Marcos received another batch of ambassadors and foreign station representatives here in his headquarters in Mandaluyong City. Those who paid him their respective courtesy calls were UK Ambassador Laurie Bofills and Singaporean Ambassador Gerard Ho. Ho and Bofills faced journalists after their respective calls to President-elect Marcos. Ho Baird, he conveyed his country's warm congratulations to Marcos and spoke with the incoming Philippine chief executive about the long-standing relationship between the Philippines and Singapore towards peace and prosperity in the region. He said President-elect Marcos spoke about conversations his father, the late President Ferdinand Marcos Sr., had with Singapore's founding father, Lee Kuan Yew. Ho said Singapore is one of the Philippines' largest trading partners, and his country is hopeful that with the resumption of cross-border travel and significant economic reforms under the current administration, bilateral economic relations between our two countries shall continue to flourish. He said Singapore sees a lot of growth potential in the Philippines and hopes to see more Singaporean investors coming into the Philippine market, especially with some reforms in the tax structure and ease of doing business instituted by the current or the Duterte administration. Ho reiterated President Halima Yacob's earlier invitation for Marcos to make a state visit to Singapore, the first state visit invitation extended to the incoming president. UK Ambassador Bofills, for her part, said the meeting with President-elect Marcos was very useful, very informative, and very warm. Those were her own words. She said the UK intends to continue its strong bilateral relationship with the Philippines throughout the course of President-elect Marcos's administration. Areas of joint interest discussed by Bofills and Marcos include the post-pandemic economy, support to trade, investments, and infrastructure, energy, climate change, the peace process in Mindanao, and human rights and media freedom. Bofills also said her country will continue to work with the Philippines and all partners in maintaining the international maritime law, the UNCLOS, and the arbitral award in favor of the Philippines over the West Philippine Sea issue in the years to come. Now, we have yet to receive updates about President-elect Marcos's meeting with the French and EU heads of station, also scheduled this morning. These are latest updates from the BBN headquarters here in Mandaluyong City. AC, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Ina Reformina, there joining us on the line.